Blah blah blah, 1, 2, 3. Hello. Today's Facebook Hacker Cup round 2. The first serious round because only top 200 advances. So this time I don't really have time to screw around. Maybe I can already create the first file, ACPP. Because likely I will start from that just after the contest. So if you're watching this shortly after I upload, likely we are still live with Lawrence on Twitch to comment problems a little bit. Go to twitch.tv/whatever you see here, Eknerwala. See this link should also be in the description. Yeah. Facebook Hacker Cup for the win. I don't have a Facebook Hacker Cup t-shirt, at least it wasn't at the top of my drawer. Let's go. Sounds easy. Can go here. This is running. I can read once more. Actually, I can submit and then think. A.out and ACPP. One more minute of thinking if everything is fine, because I can still resubmit. I think I use long longs whenever necessary. I compute how many must go in. Must go out. Additionally, can in or can out. If I need 4 in and 10 out, they will be matched, but I need 6 more. Yeah, so that's maximum. Looks fine. Oh, I'm winning. Yay. More views on YouTube. Hooray. I don't know what is this word. Do they mean competition? Well, I can do quadratic DP. Is that it? DP of better and worse. Just need to do it backwards. So this is expected number EV of remaining matches. If there are that many people better than you and worse than you. (64 × W), yeah, it will fit. I will just compute it once. Preprocessing. Not once. P is given in every test, right? Okay, then it's not preprocessing anymore. For every guy now. Starting from somebody weak. Better than you. probability that they meet. One match because we are still alive. Sorry that I'm not explaining everything. I will do that after the contest. Minus one. This should be at least two. instead of analyzing the sample output, I can just do this big file. And now, what about 8000, 0.75? Oh, fast enough. Know what I will do? I will see if maybe answers differ a lot if I change everything to long double. The differences are very small. I bet that if I change this to 8, there will be no differences. Ah. Eighth position. Yeah, that's fine. How is it going on? It's fine. Beautiful. I'm testing a little bit because passing problems is here more important than winning. Circles of size M. Okay. I need to remove one blue edge, the biggest blue edge for sure, otherwise we have a cycle. And I will remove one more edge, and either it's a red edge, or we leave all red edges and we remove one blue edge. But removing blue edge shouldn't make the single circle disjoint. If already the maximum edge was in one half of a circle, we must remove something on the other half. Sounds easy. Sure. I don't know what are upper links for I. Oh, and here we go. N. N. Those are costs. What are the initial costs? Oh, here. One. Okay. Second max from circle will just go to red. Shouldn't this be two multisets? There is X, there is Y. Does it matter which one is where? I think it doesn't. Everything between them will be one part. Is, let's say, starting guy. No, I don't need those in a set. This will be just a sum. It was the number of changes, yes. Circle of I of half erase. Alt weight. New weight. And now I need to update some stuff like this. Otherwise, it's a red edge. That should be easy. What do I print? The product. No way. Nice. Very nice. If it works here, then likely there are no overflows. Here you go, the source code. And are we fast enough? Okay. One more read, and also I will run it with different compilation method. Just in case there are overflows going outside of the array, stuff like that. Values are up to billion, right? So nothing can exceed long here. Still second, BenQ above me. Yup, but just by a little bit. The fact that this is slow doesn't matter. My advice, always skip the first paragraph. They love tree problems, don't they? again. They should provide code for, you know, generating this. Any drawing, please? I bet this will be related to convex hulls. As pre-processing for every subtree, I can know what the score if I start here without any good driver. But if there is a good driver starting here, it might change my optimal decision. Because there might be some short path. Anything is small, not really values up to a million. We need to add concave functions. Not add, minimize. Take minimum of two concave functions. We can do smaller to greater. And that's possible if we keep logarithmically many objects. Then there are queries. I don't need to remember that because queries are given, I think. Now, is there an easy way to represent the lines? Because in a subtree, I basically will need to get to some vertex, and from there, I know a fixed cost. Here we go, so that you could see as well. They read from 1. I read from 0. As always, this was quite annoying. If I want numbering from 0, decrease the parents. This is length. Then X and Y are queries. Oh, I shouldn't do this. Minus minus here, minus minus on the right. What is Y? And the starting speed. When you use global stuff, it's better to make a struct. Lengths are up to 1 million. This is also up to 1 million. Right. I think I'm reading correctly. Yep. What else am I doing here? You will give me an object. This will be struct, call it S, whatever. first a brute force. Add a line. Get min. I don't know if that's the case. I just need to add one new thing, right? At every vertex, there lives a driver. I need infinity, damn it. I thought that I could avoid it. He also has some DP. IDP is menu of itself, comma. That's my DP. I claim that I need this. Now queries. And y are of the same size. this is temporary. Later I need to print some product or something again. I don't think those are correct answers. Minus my speed times my depth. Am I close? Not at all. Much more reasonable values. Usually missing by one or two. Wait, what? Did they remove something? It should be speed times depth, right? And 14.9, okay, close, close. His depth. Times somebody's speed. But what speed? Good. Now let's save this just in case I will remove it by mistake. Now I return index or pointer instead of the whole struct. Next thing is smaller to greater. Just to check if anything reasonable happens. Yeah. Okay, this is small to greater. And now this should be Convex hull. Sort by decreasing slope. I'm not using it yet. To do, I need to handle parallel lines. intersection of two lines. Divided by okay. And now this shouldn't be greater equal, it should be it works. The bigger values here are, the more I can trust that it really worked. Does something. And no assert fails, by the way. What now? What now? This should be single convex hull. What's the condition? Well, your size is smaller or equal mine. I don't want 4-3. It's smaller than double my size. Okay, last thing. Maybe this should be able to just add a vector of lines, it will be faster. This doesn't hurt. Oh, it works. First validation, and then assert failed. Yeah, I would forget. Parallel lines. I'm happy that there are some big samples. Wrong answer. What about that? Maybe after like 5 minutes I will get this output, and then I will also see if it's correct. And it's unique, so I will save it and I will be able to locally know what should be the output. How easy it is to generate tests. There are two ways. Either I modify here, stuff inside. I think I will do so. First, what about reading everything? Sort decreasingly by slopes. Return a pair such the second value is. It's positive. If the last element has the same slope, choose the better constant, remove that guy. Okay. If you're not in proper order, remove B, otherwise break, add U. Binary search. When do I build? After merging with somebody. Yeah, wrong output. Interesting. Very interesting. What do I print? Maybe I should first check this. It's correct. Something is very wrong. Well, I'm not wrong, but something is for sure suspicious because I'm passing random tests generated by me. So who knows? This is to check for overflows. We have overflows. 104. Here I thought that isn't the first number just depth? But I thought it's at most 10 to 12. I can just cast to int 128, but I need to understand what I'm doing. A pair comes from B, the first element in the pair. Okay, what is B? Here we go. Now I understand. Let's I tried binary tree, star and line. Everything works fast enough. To check for overflows, but I can already choose the code. D.out. I wasted too much time on this. On this overflow thing. Oh. So without that I would be third, fourth or so. I don't know. I will check later in recording how long that was. As I said already, go to Twitch, not me, Eknerwall. We will, just after the round stops, we will talk about problems and about the competition. When this video goes live, you likely can go there, link also in the description, and you will see us live. See you then, and thank you for watching. Bye-bye.